Here with Mari Kim. This is her studio. Hi, Mari.
Hi.
Oh, it's great to see you.
Great to see you too. Yeah. How are you?
I'm good. Good.
So, Mari, you studied in Australia after graduating high school.
Yeah.
So, why did you choose to go to Australia?
I watched a lot of Japanese animation when I was young, and all the girls in Japanese animation, they lived in Australia with the sheep, and they pick up fruits from the woods, and I thought that was paradise, and I wanted to go to Australia. I told my mom, I want to go to Australia because I didn't study really well. So my mom said, okay, you can at least learn English. So go and do whatever for 1 year. And then I didn't really come back. I told my mom, I want to do this. I want to do this in Australia. I had a lot of things to do in Australia. And then, I don't know, I wanted to live in Australia.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So how long did you stay in Australia?
Almost 10 years.
10 years?
Yes.
It's like Australian.
Yeah, yeah. I actually hold an Australian citizenship.
Ah, yep. So like
you're Australian.
Korean.
Korean.
Yep, yep.
Yeah.
So, and then when you go to Australia, you studied animation and creative media at the Royal Melbourne University. Is that
right? RMIT. So-called.
So tell me about your experience at the school and your major.
I didn't get into the school at the first. I studied a certificate course to begin with,
right,
at the beginning, and I made my portfolio to get into RMIT because RMIT was good school. And when I first studied in Australia, I didn't really know I want to study this because, as I told you, I didn't like studying very much.
Right.
Yeah, but I always find cartoons and animation very fascinating, and I like to draw a lot when I was younger, but I didn't know that can be a job or a profession. So I studied a little bit and I liked it very much, and I find whole kind of new world. So you can draw a lot of things from using computer. And then that kind of changed my view of drawings and creating things. And I found myself, I was very passionate about it. And then I finally find myself liking studying then.
Studying animation.
Yes. And then I studied quite well then. Because when I was in Korea, I didn't study well, and my mom kind of gave up for me to study. But I actually find myself studying very well. So I should do this. And I kept on going. So I studied for a long time, and then I actually finished my master's degree.
Until a master's degree.
Yes.
First, you studied with the certificate.
Yep.
And then you got into MRIT.
RMIT.
And then you finished there, and then you continued doing a
master's.
Yeah.
Did you create this so-called idol? Mm-hmm. Is that when you started at Australia? When you're ready to make a portfolio?
I didn't really know how to draw because I didn't learn to draw. But I liked drawing, so I read a lot of comic books, and then I've got the styles from the comic books, and then draw a lot of things from the comic books. I copied a lot of things actually, but gradually I developed my style. I always like to draw face wider than longer. So it's wider, and then the eyes big, and then it's kind of tilt to the side. So it's kind of cat's eyes.
Right.
Yeah, I like that style. And then I drew that a lot, and then I uploaded my drawings to the blog, and then I named it Idol. And then actually I published the book in year 2007, Idol. Ever since then, this character became Idol. Everyone calls it.
Did you call it Idol in the beginning or?
I didn't really, actually.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it wasn't named
that
from you.
Didn't have a name, but the book title was Idol, and then ever since then I named it Idol.
I drew
a lot of things back then, and then I actually wrote about this stories. So it's a graphic novel
also. So this books, everything is where you put it on blog.
That's right.
Oh wow. So yeah, social network. I want to talk about social network. Unlike now, most people, they use a social network to promote them or just talk about it. You use it in the very, very early beginning. Mm-hmm. Why did you choose to use social network to draw? You say you put it every day on the vlog.
If I studied art, I don't think I ever used SNS, social media, to promote my work. Talking about promotion, I didn't really think that was promotion at all. I didn't really know what to do with my drawings and paintings, because after I studied from Australia, I came back to Korea, but I didn't really know what to do. So I didn't really know how to earn money to live in Korea. But I know how to draw using computers. But I didn't think that can be art, that they can be exhibited. Because I didn't study art, so I don't know exhibition. I don't know how to exhibit, how to work with gallery. I don't know curators. I don't know any galleries in Korea. But I wanted to draw, so I drew a lot of things. I think I drew one painting or drawings and sketches. I do it more than one every day for 2 years. And then I uploaded these contents to Korean blog, Naver. So I made more than 700 updates through 2 years.
Wow.
So back then I uploaded a lot of contents, and then they put me on the first page, and then people get to see my work, and then I kind of developed a lot of fans and follows.
Through blogs.
If I studied art, I don't think I ever uploaded any contents to the SNS, because in the classic art business, they don't really reveal their work before the exhibition. But I didn't really know, because I didn't study art. I think that was my difference and then disadvantage, but became an advantage.
You didn't study art, and that kind of put you into thinking you should use a social network.
The world was kind of changing, and then I was a new kind of artist. They needed, but classically they don't know this kind of art, so a lot of people didn't really think this is art, but some people think this is art.
So it's like Andy Warhol, like back then, like when he was doing something unconventional, it wasn't there before, and then all of a sudden people are like, why do you call it art? So it's kind of like very similar in pop artists in a way. Back in 50s to 70s, all the pop artists, they used a lot of different mediums, and you know, unlike before, they used painting, brush.